Okay, so let's go into some more details on cloud endpoints. You probably remember this picture from lesson 2, where we introduced cloud endpoints, and where we described this capability to create one API that you could use to create client applications for many different devices. Well, you may wonder now, why is cloud endpoints any different from a pure HTTP protocol? For example, a REST API. Well, let's look at that. When using cloud endpoints, it allows the development environment to inspect and be aware of your API. This has multiple values. First of all, application design. When designing your backend application, you can focus on the high-level application design, and you don't need to think about low-level communication syntax and semantics. Cloud Endpoints also performs native client library generation for a number of different languages. This helps out greatly with a number of different things. For example, communication and establishing connectivity, and error management, so you don't have to deal with low-level communication errors, but also higher-level functions such as user authentication that we used for Conference Central. And also, since your API can be expected, Google can provide many tools around it. The API Explorer is just one example of such a tool, which is extremely useful. So Cloud Endpoints is a great way to develop APIs that are rock solid, easy to use, portable across devices and languages, and can be used with tools such as the API Explorer. Great value here, in other words, since it lets you focus on your app and let Google take care of all the low-level details. Let's now look at Cloud Endpoints in your development environment.